So it turns out, and it makes me crazy, but one of the fastest growing sources of computer spending in American business today is technology designed to automate and computerize 1-800 call centers. Now, you guys are customers, you know, you've all had this experience. You've got a question about a product, you dial the 1-800 number, and you get one of those damn computerized voice prompts. It says, you know, press 1 for price information, press 2 for warranty information, press 3 to check in your status of your order. You press one of those numbers, and you get another computerized voice prompt. And on it goes. And companies spend $10 billion a year on the technology to inflict this computerized voice upon you. Now, it turns out, even in this age of computerization and automation, you can reach a real live human being behind all of these numbers. The trouble is, you can't do it at all anymore just by pressing 0. Every company has got a code to get you to a person, but they never tell you the code. And so you're sort of poking around and pulling out your hair, and eventually, maybe on a good day, you crack it and get somebody on the line. So if you want to reach Honeywell, the electronics and automation company, you dial their 1-800 number, you dial 990011, and a human being pops up. If you want to reach Aflac, you know, Aflac, the insurance company with the ducks or the cute ads, you dial ###3 and a human being or the duck pops up and talks to you. If my favorite one is, if you want to check on your rebate from Office Max, you dial 222-000, put in your phone number, ##, and a human being answers the phone. Now, if all these codes are secret, how do I know them? Because there has emerged in the land a movement called gethuman.com. And there are volunteers all over the world, and the minute somebody cracks one of these codes, they go to the Get Human website and they put it on the database. And so if you want to have a sobering rendezvous with sort of what's going on in American business today, go to gethuman.com. They've got probably 450, 500 brands, departments, companies by name on there, and look at the maniacal codes that are in there to sort of keep you away from dealing with a human being. Now, it's funny because, you know, as I say, I go and talk to a lot of companies, and invariably at some point the CEO will say, Bill, let me tell you, we expect to improve our products and services by listening to the voice of the customer. Well, here's an idea. Answer the damn phone when they call you, right? It's not that complicated to pull off, but